Somebody took my heat transfer book!
James! Mickey! I need your help right away!
Thanks for coming, guys.
We got a problem.
Justin! What's the problem?
There's a torch! The torch is imparting some sort of heat flux to this aluminum rod here. It's losing energy due to convection through to the outside, but there's still energy making it all the way back to the book over here. So we need to find out how soon we have until the book explodes.
What are we gonna do?
Stop whining. Apply energy balance.
To what?
The differential element of the rod.
Oh, yeah.
What does the heat profile look in it? Like this?
Well, no, not linear. The slope is going to get smaller as you go out because the heat flux will be less because it's carrying less energy.
Like this?
Idiot.
Cancel the heat.
Now what?
Second order linear constant coefficient differential equation with a temporal dimension.
Wow, Justin, that's really ugly.
It is. We can never solve it analytically.
We can solve it numerically.
Numerically? Excellent idea, Nikki. To the FemLab mobile.
Motor Racer X, this is J Falcon Beta.
Do you read me?
Hi, Justin, I just got to the lab. Where are you?
Running aimlessly, do you have any idea where my book could be?
Yeah, I just searched Google Images for Justin's heat transfer book, and I got a picture from recent surveillance footage. Then I used 3D image extrapolation and cross-referenced the 3D data with floor plans of all the buildings on UCSB.
Fantastic, Motor Racer, where is it?
You're not gonna believe this, Justin, but it's in the secret subterranean fission power core below Stork Tower.
You're right. I don't believe you. I'm on my way.
You want to take my bike?
No, thanks. I need the exercise.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Wait, Nikki.
Yeah?
Is there a chance that the convective heat transfer coefficient will be sufficiently high that the steady state temperature of my book won't reach the flash point of paper?
I don't know. I'll do some steady state analysis on the thing.
Okay. J Falcon out.
Mothership Bravo, this is J Monkey Beta. Do you read me?
Hey, Justin, what's up?
Motor Racer X has just informed me that the book is in a secret fission facility below Stork Tower.
Can you give me the access code so that we can sneak in?
I'll try. I'm beginning to run a FemLab simulation to get the transient response of the rod.
Great. J-Monkey out. Motor Mr. Seda, this is J-Dog Omnicron. How's it going at the steady state analysis lab?
Hey Justin, here's the deal. If you assume the temperature is radially constant and you're looking for the final steady state temperature, then the problem becomes a simple one-dimensional fin problem with convection at the sides, so we can find out whether the book will actually get to the ignition point of paper, 350 degrees C.
Alright, what's it looking like?
Not good. If we've only got natural convection and we're not letting any energy escape through the book end of the rod, the final steady state temperature at the end of the rod is about 1000 degrees.
Celsius or Fahrenheit?
Does it matter?
No, you're right. Is there any way you can buy us some time?
There are cooling fans in the fission core. I'll see if I can hack into the mainframe and activate them.
Fantastic!
Increasing the convection coefficient, or lowering T infinity, will increase the amount of energy taken away from the rod. It'll slow down the energy as it propagates down the rod, as well as lower the steady state temperature.
Alright, figure that out and then tell me what the next steady state temperature will be. I'm gonna call James the FemLab.
Here, why don't you just...
J-Dog out!
Mega Man Kamel, this is Jay Maestro, Capsilon. How's it going with the FemLab simulation?
Fine, Justin. I'm looking at the one-dimensional transient response of the rod. I got a mesh set up, and I've set boundary conditions.
Great! What are they?
We got the torch pumping in a constant energy on the left here, and the energy propagates down the rod, heating it up.
What about convection?
To get a worst-case scenario, I left out the effect of convection, so all the energy stays in the rod. I have adiabatic boundary conditions set on the sides of the rod and the end, where the book is.
Fine. How much time do we have until the rod heats up to 350 C?
It's not looking good. Did Nikki tell you what the steady state temperature is already?
Yeah, don't remind me.
Let's just say that you don't have any time to waste.
She might be able to get the convective heat transfer coefficient higher by turning on the fans. Let me see how she's doing with that.
Hey, let me just...
Cycle Duchess, this is JP Worldride. Where are you?
Hi, Justin. I've got a plot of steady state temperature of the book as a function of the heat transfer coefficient.
How's it look?
Not great. In order to get the steady state temperature below the ignition point of the paper, we need an H of at least 65. The best I can get with the fans is about 20, which still brings us to about 600 degrees.
Okay, then we'll have to work fast. I'm gonna call James in the FEM analysis lab and see where he is.
Wait, Justin. Let me just put him on. Hey, James, it's for you.
I got him, Justin. We'll be right there.
Oh, okay. I'll see you there.